This is Akanksha from English Logger. In the previous video, we have learned about adjectives and its types. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn about degrees of comparison. We have 3 degrees of comparison: positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. What is positive degree? When we are not making any comparison, that is positive degree. What is comparative degree? When we are making comparison between 2 persons and 2 things, that is comparative degree. What is superlative degree? Superlative degree means when we are making comparison between more than 2 persons or more than 2 things, that is superlative degree. More you will learn in this video, how to make it, how to use it in your sentence: positive degree, superlative degree, and comparative degree, and how to identify also. I just hope that you will learn and you will share my channel, you will subscribe. The very first we have positive degree, next comparative degree, and the third one is superlative degree. Here we have few examples of positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree, just to find out the difference between all these 3 degrees. First, positive degree: rich, high, good, brave, dry, careful, honest. Comparative degree: richer, higher, better, braver, drier, more careful, more honest. Superlative degree: richest, highest, best, bravest, driest, most careful, most honest. What are the difference between in these 3 degrees? Like in positive, I have written rich, and when rich comes in comparative degree, it becomes richer, and in superlative degree, it becomes richest. So what is the difference between comparative and superlative? ER and EST. Here you can see the second last example and the last example: more careful and more change into most and superlative. And similarly here, more honest, and here is most honest. Positive degree. What's the definition of positive degree? An adjective is in positive degree when no comparison is made and the word is used in its base form. For example, like you can say that it denotes the existence of any quality which is spoken about. For example, clever. We are not using clever or cleverest. That's the example of comparative degree and superlative degree. So basically, in positive degree, you have to use just the base form of the verb without ER or EST. It's just a simple word, and that is positive degree. Here are few examples in a sentence form. This house is big. Here, no comparison is made. He is a tall boy. This flower is beautiful. He is an intelligent boy. So you can see over here, we have used positive degree and we are not making any type of comparison between 2 things or 2 persons. So these are the examples of positive degree. Next we have definition of comparative degree. What is comparative degree? When we are making comparison between 2 things or 2 persons, or you can say that like when we are doing comparison between 2 persons or 2 things or a set of persons or things, like it denotes a higher degree of quality. For instance, cleverer. In positive, it was clever, and now in comparative, it becomes cleverer. ER we have added, and that shows that we are doing comparison between 2 persons. Here we have examples of comparative degree. Rama is braver than Balu.
Iron is more useful than any other metal. Mercury is smaller than Saturn. Sam is cleverer than John. So here, braver, more useful, smaller, cleverer. What are these? These are comparative degrees when we are making comparison between two persons or two things. Next we have superlative degree. That we use the superlative degree of an adjective when we compare more than two persons or things or set of persons or things. It denotes the highest degree of quality. For instance, cleverest. Here are examples of superlative degree. He is the most intelligent boy in the class. Most intelligent. Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system. Lead is the heaviest of all metals. Chennai is one of the biggest of Indian cities. Tennyson is not the greatest of all poets. So here we have given examples of superlative degrees, which shows that we are making comparison, but we are making comparison between more than two persons or two things.
Here is one exercise for you. Just wait a sec. Yeah. Find out the adjectives and name the degrees of comparison. So here in this exercise, what you're supposed to do is you have to find out the adjective and then you have to find out degrees of comparison. So your very first sentence is, no news is good news. So according to me, good is an adjective, and as it is not showing any comparison between two things, so according to me it is a positive degree of comparison. So next is, he is a brave boy. According to me, brave is an adjective, and again we are not making any comparison, so again it is a positive degree. Next is, make less noise. So here less is an adjective, and again no comparison is there, so that is positive degree. These are very simple sentences. I can say that he has many powerful fins. Powerful is an adjective, no comparison here also, so that is again positive degree. My knife is sharper than yours. Sharper. So it shows that comparison between my knife and yours one. So that is comparative degree. Comparison between two things, and ER is also here. So that makes comparative degree. Next is, Solomon was one of the wisest men. Wisest. So here we are making comparison, but making comparison between more than two things or two men over here. So that is superlative degree. Thank you for subscribing my channel. Here's a subscribe button over here. You can see. Do not forget to subscribe for the further video of mine to get the notification of that. Thank you and have a nice day.